if you're interested in taking a photograph with a smartphone like this through the eyepiece of your telescope, binocular, microscope or monoscope, then you're going to have real problems, because lining up the camera with the eyepiece, getting it really central, getting it into focus and taking a picture is really difficult. But thankfully, there are adapters on the market that help you to do this by attaching your phone firmly and accurately in exactly the right position to take your photo. And today, we're going to be looking at a product from Apexel called the APL F002X Rotatable Telescope Phone Adapter. Now, before I show you the actual adapter, I firstly want to show you a couple of things that is useful to do on your phone before you start. And the first one is to take off the auto macro function. So if you just put your hand close to the lens, you'll get this macro symbol will appear in the bottom left-hand corner. And you just touch on there, this is on iPhone, and disable that mode. And that will mean that you're always imaging through this lens here, which is the normal lens. The other thing is, you don't want to be clamping your phone onto this rubber eyepiece only for the eyepiece to pull off and your precious smartphone to drop on the ground. So I recommend that you remove any rubber eye cup from the eyepiece before you attach anything. So now we've done those two things, we're ready to look at the adapter. So this is the Apexel adapter, essentially a plastic product, and it has spring-loaded clamps. This is the clamp for the eyepiece, and it will adjust automatically to an eyepiece with a diameter between 23 and 50 millimeters and just clamps onto the eyepiece like that. On the other side, we have this additional spring-loaded clamp, and this will open quite wide, allowing you to take smartphones that are between 66 and 96 millimeters wide. Now we can do the alignment of the camera lens with this hole here in this direction simply by sliding the phone into the right position this way. But we also have this thumb screw here, which when we unlock it, we can move the whole phone side to side to get the alignment in the other direction. So once we've aligned our camera with the hole, then we can simply mount our camera to the eyepiece. So let's do that now with the iPhone. Now on the iPhone, the power button and the volume buttons are actually going to end up being inside the clamp, which is not a great thing. So what we need to do is make sure the phone is on and we've disabled that macro, auto macro mode. Then we can put the camera into the holder. We need to get it reasonably square, and the camera's turned off on me, which is just showing you the kind of problems that you can have. So we'll open it up again, pop it in. Okay. So we're not lined up with the hole just yet, so we'll slide it up and down. We can look on this side and see where our alignment needs to be. Undo the thumb screw, slide it across, and we're almost perfectly lined up with the hole now. And then just looking at this angle, you can see I'm on a bit of a tilt. I need to lift the iPhone up a bit so that the lens is resting level. There are some pads, sticky pads, that come with the adapter to help you put spacers in there to get that a little easier. But you see now that we are successfully looking through the hole in the adapter. I can just adjust it sideways ever so slightly. I can probably get a slightly better alignment, maybe there. And we're now ready to put the adapter onto the telescope. And as you can see, we're now looking very nicely through the telescope. Now the adapter comes with this little remote camera release. It's got an iOS button and an Android button, so I assume it will work with either type of smartphone. And that's really nice, it means you don't have to be touching the phone to take your picture. You can do it remotely with this shutter. That's really good. Another thing I didn't mention is, because of the way it clamps onto the telescope, it's actually very easy to rotate your camera to frame your shot differently, so that's fine. But since the view is predominantly circular, it's probably less important. Okay, I've got my 8-inch Newtonian telescope set up pointing at the sun. I've got the solar filter on the front of it, obviously, to protect the telescope and eyes and cameras. And I've focused with the eyepiece, and I've taken the rubber eye cup off. I've got the iPhone all set up here in the adapter, ready to go straight on the telescope. So pop it on the telescope, like so. And we've got a lovely view. Just move the camera around so you can see what I'm seeing. There we go. Hopefully you've got a good view of that now. And all I need to do now is make sure I'm focusing on something. And let's check the focus looks good, yes. And I can press a button to take a shot. Maybe take a couple. I can switch to video mode. Zoom in. I just want to recenter that. I'm just going to use the mount to just move the sun up into the center of the shot. Just let the wobble decay. And now I'm going to shoot, say, 10 seconds of video. So just a single press on the remote. And press again to stop. So really a very stable setup, very easy to use, and the adapter is doing its job very nicely indeed. So overall, I'm pretty impressed. In fact, more impressed than I thought I would be by this device. Even though it's plastic, it feels pretty solid. It holds onto your phone very firmly, and it's not going to drop it on the floor. And I found it really easy to use. I did have that one niggle with the clamp turning my phone off sometimes. But after a bit of practice, that problem went away. If you want to get one of these, please do look in the description under the video, because there's a link in there that will give you a 10% discount. Hope you enjoyed the review. See you next time, and clear skies.